welcome. I am your fellow servant, Evangelist Daud Kaime. The sermon that we are going to share together is coming from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, and Romans chapter 1, verse 17, and Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. But before we go in further, shall we inquire the Lord in prayer? Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We bless your name. Thank you very much for according us this wonderful time, Heavenly Father, of sharing your word with my brothers and sisters who are listening to me right now. Father, we thank you that you have given us this wonderful opportunity of life so that, Heavenly Father, we may experience the power, we may experience you as our God. Even in this difficult time, Heavenly Father, you want to reveal yourself to us. You want us to know that there is a Father who cares for us even in difficult times. Father, we thank you that you have answered our prayer, because we pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Master, we pray. Amen. Let me go through the verses that I gave you earlier. I'm starting with 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Listen to what the Bible says. The Bible says, "For we live by faith and not by sight." For we live by faith and not by sight. Romans chapter 1, verse 17, the Bible says, Romans chapter 1, verse 17. Listen to what the Bible says in Romans chapter 1, verse 17. "For in the gospel, the righteousness of God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from first to last. Just as it is written, the righteous shall live by faith." So the righteous shall live by faith. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. So that we hear what the Lord wants to speak to us. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. The Bible says, "Now faith is the confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see." Other version says, "Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen." So now when we look at 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 7 says, "For we do not live by sight, but we move by faith." And the title of our sharing this evening or this time is "Not by sight, but by faith." Not by sight, but by faith. Now, when you look at the Bible and the verses that we have read, God is saying, we don't walk by sight, we walk by faith. Or we do not operate by sight, we operate by faith. You should know for sure that if God operates by faith, the enemy will operate by sight. Because if God says we do not move by faith, by sight, but by faith, you should know that the enemy always operates by sight. So the devil operates on the things that we see, the things that we touch, the things that we hear, the situation. So whatever situation you are going through, the devil will bring a situation to you, and you look at the situation, and the situation will seem to be bigger than your belief. But God says, do not walk by sight, but move by faith. And the Bible defines faith to say is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. And we do not operate by sight, we operate by faith. So what the devil does is this: he brings situation, difficult things, so that you can live by sight. And whenever you are living by what you are seeing, you live with fear. So what the devil wants is to bring fear in your life, to bring fear in your career, to bring fear in your business, to bring fear in your situation, so that when you see your situation is going down, when you see your family they are breaking up, when you see your marriage is not going well, and the devil will tell you this is the end of your life. But that's what you are seeing, that's what you are able to see, that's what you are able to hear. You don't operate by what you see, because what you see brings fear. But God says we operate by faith. What is faith? The substance of things hoped for. What are you hoping for? You are hoping for a better life. That's where we live. You are hoping for
a successive marriage, a successive business. And the Bible says, stop operating or moving by sight, start moving by faith. And faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. You know what? When the devil brings a difficult situation in your life, speak faith. Speak what you want to see, because you are hoping for a better thing. Speak what you want to see. The devil says, you will die, you are sick, you are not going to make it, you are not going to find a job. Tell the devil to say, I don't walk by sight. Sight tells me, yes, I don't have. Sight tells me, yes, I'm sick, I have symptoms. Sight tells me, yes, I don't have a man. Sight tells me, yes, we are having marital problems. But faith tells you, you have everything in God. Start speaking what you want to see. We don't walk by sight. Even what we are seeing right now, the economy and everything, this is what sight is telling you. This is what you are hearing. This is what you are moving at. But the Bible says we don't operate on what we see or hear. We operate on faith. My brother and my sister, if there is a time that daughters of God should start living by faith and not by sight, is now, because things are changing. Everything is changing. You need to focus and start living by faith and not by sight. The devil wants to insinuate and bring fear in your life by what? By bringing difficult situation. When you look at the economy, you look at the family that you have, you look at your businesses are going down, and then the devil will come and tell you to say, you know what? You will suffer, you will die. That is sight. Tell him to say, I don't live by sight. I live by faith. I don't live by what you are seeing. What you are seeing is not what I live for. I live by faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. You are not seeing my business. You are not seeing my life. You are not seeing my future. But I have seen it. I have moved it by faith, because you live now. Me, I don't live now. I live by faith in Christ. Brothers and sisters, no matter how things may seem to be hard in your life, don't live by what you see. Don't live by what you hear. Don't live by feelings. Live by faith. God says, for the righteous shall live by faith. My brother, my sister, live by faith. Trust God in whatever situation. No matter how difficult your situation may be, no matter how difficult your circumstance may be, but I want to tell you to say, that's what you are able to see. That's what you are seeing. That's not your reality. That's not your true reality. Your true reality is what God speaks on your life, the faith that you believe, the hope that you have in God. That's your reality. What you are seeing is the devil trying to insinuate fear in you, but that's not who you are. That's not your situation. That's not your true report. Your true report is in what the Bible says. The Bible says, my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory. He says, 1,000 shall fall on my right side, 10,000 on my left side. Nothing shall come near me. He prepares the table before my enemy. No weapon fashioned against us shall prosper. Why? Because we don't move by sight, we move by faith. Brother, my sister, this is the time to change your strategy. Stop living by what you see. Stop living by what you hear. Stop living by feelings. Start living by faith. Because when you live by faith, you live a step ahead. The devil lives now. The devil does not know the future. Demons do not know the future. Only God has the future. And God says, don't live by what you see. Live by what God speaks about your life. I don't know your situation. Some of you are sick. You say, like, am I going to be healed? The devil will come and tell you to say, you are not going to be healed, you die. But that's not your true report. The Bible says, by his wounds we are healed. You are healed. Start speaking what you are hoping for. The Bible says, faith is the substance of things hoped for. What are you hoping for? You are hoping for healing. Start speaking it. Start speaking it. When you read the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6, you read from verse 13, the Bible says, for we have the same faith, the same spirit of faith. We have the same spirit of faith. For what I want to see, I speak. You speak what you want to see. You speak what you want to have. You speak. Why? Because you live by faith. Faith speaks. Jesus says, if you have little faith as a mustard seed, you will speak to the mulberry tree to say, plant yourself, be uprooted by the roots, and throw yourself in the river, it will do that. You can speak to the mountain. If you have a faith as small as mustard seed, you will speak to the mountain. You will speak to the tree. You will speak. Start speaking what you want to see, because you don't walk by sight. Sight deceives. Sight brings fear. Sight brings distrust. Sight brings defeat. But start walking by faith. If there is a time, my brother, my sister, when you need to start walking by faith, is now. Now is the time. The Bible says we don't walk by sight, we walk by faith. The just shall live by faith. And faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. You might not see it, believe you have it. You might not see it, believe you have it. Jesus said in the book of Mark chapter 11 verse 24, to say whatever you desire, by prayer, believe you have received it and it shall be yours. Believe you have received it and it shall be yours. When you desire something, you pray, you kneel down, Lord, I need this. The Bible says, believe there and then that you have received it. Faith tells you, I have it. Even if you cannot see it right there and then, the Bible says, when you believe you have it, it shall be yours. So when someone comes and tells you, you tell them to say, my business is going up. People will say, are you mad? How can you say your business? How can you say? Tell them to say, I don't live by sight. Sight is telling you something different. But I'm believing what God says. When you pray, believe you have received it. I've received it already. I cannot see it, but it is manifesting. It is coming. Because God says, I live by faith. You owe it. When you pray, you know, many other times I tell people, I tell friends, I tell people that I've been praying for. They ask me, how does God answer prayer? I've been praying for this for 1 year now, for 6 months now. I've been praying for this for this period. I tell them to say, you know what? The reason why you've been praying for the same thing for 1 year, it is because you have not believed that God has answered you. You have not seen it. You have not believed. But the Bible says when you pray, believe you have received it and it shall be yours. There is a process when you pray, believe that God, thank you, I have received it. Thank you, Lord. So that time when you are believing you have received it, you don't have it yet. But by faith, you have the evidence because you know that God has answered your prayer. Stop praying for the same thing again and again. No, when you pray once, believe you have received it. All you need to do is say, thank you, Lord, I have received healing in my life. Thank you, Lord, I have a job. Even when you are not working right now, because you have prayed and you know that God has answered, start living to say, thank you, Jesus, I have a job. Believe you have received it. And the Bible says, it shall be yours. So there's a process of believing you have received it, even before you can see it, because it's the evidence of things unseen. You are not seeing them, but you have the evidence in your hands. And you walk by faith and you say, Lord, thank you, I have it. And let me tell you this, you shall see it. What is your situation? What are you going through? When you pray, believe you have received it. For we do not walk by sight, but we walk by faith. May God bless you. May God bless everyone who is watching to me right now. Whatever things that you desire by prayer, believe it is done. Shall we close our eyes as we pray together? Father, thank you very much for this wonderful message that you have given us. Thank you, Heavenly Father, that you have called us not to walk by sight. You have called us to walk by faith. Sight brings fear. Sight, Heavenly Father, brings insecurity, but faith gives us evidence, hope, and confidence. Thank you, Father, that you have answered our prayer. Thank you, Lord, that you are in control. Thank you, Lord, that we don't walk by our situation right now. Thank you, Jesus, that you are in control and we will live by faith and not by sight. Yes, Heavenly Father, the devil will bring insinuations, his schemes, he will throw arrows to us. But the Bible says we have the shield of faith, where we quench all the arrows of the enemy. The devil will send arrows, fiery darts to us. We quench it by faith, because faith is believing God for what he said he will do to us. Thank you, Jesus. Bless that mother. Bless that woman. Bless that brother. Bless that father who is listening to us right now. May you touch their life. Reach to their point of need. In Jesus' name we thank you and we pray. Amen. God bless you and enjoy your time.